It is often said that revolutions happen in the blink of an eye. In India, that eye blinked in 1991. 1991, when the ownership of a remodeled 800cc Suzuki car was the height of aspiration for an Indian. When Coke meant nothing and McDonald's was as alien as apple pie. When billionaires were unknown and a 3% GDP growth was a cause to celebrate. When the best and the brightest were fighting for government jobs, and in a year when Hollywood was planning a post-apocalyptic future with robotic assassins, Bollywood was still talking to the pigeons. All this changed when a retired politician was brought in from exile to take the place of an assassinated prime minister. Forced to sell gold to pay its bills, the ruling party finally declared India open for business. And in the blink of an eye, the shape of a new country started to form. A country that is now the second fastest growing economy in the world, the 10th largest, with the youngest workforce, and the most entrepreneurial aspiring middle class. For most Indians, though, change was not noticeable in their jobs, their living spaces, or in their grocery stores. The real revolution happened in their living rooms. Even as a shocked political class was unwinding its decades-long obsession with socialism, dish antennas started sprouting on rooftops across the country, pointed towards a distant sky that was beaming in a whole new world, a world that was being brought alive by Star. This is the story of how a new world came to be. This is the story of Star.